Hey, welcome to Spring Wind Sonic Soul Collage. Man, I've been having a really difficult time being in this depression I've been in, and I don't want to fight it really, because I know from experience that fighting it exacerbates it and can get more frustrating. At the same time, I'm needing to get moving, and so I wanted to focus on some play. And if any of you that know me very well know that comedic theater is a passion of mine, and specifically clowning. And I had the pleasure of seeing Weird Al Yankovic out at the State Fair about 10 years ago, it's probably been now, and I was just blown away. Just what a performer, what a talented performer he was, both theatrically and poetically and musically. What a great band he had together, and they've been together the whole time. So anyway, I came across this collection of people doing tributes, doing covers of Weird Al's songs, and there's some pretty neat ones in there. And so that's what this show came together from. And we're gonna let Weird Al get us started though here with Generic Blues. So get your heads right, get your heads in a fun and playful way. If not, dive in and let go, let go, let go, and you'll find the music will get you there. So let's have fun.
Bye. shoes and go bowling. Maybe I'll join a league, enter a tournament, put on a stupid looking shirt and go bowling instead. This is my last resort. Suffocation, no breathing, don't give up if I cut my arm bleeding. This is my last resort. Cause I'm losing my sight, losing my mind. Wish somebody would tell me I'm fine. Losing my sight, losing my mind. Wish somebody would tell me I'm fine. Nothing's alright, nothing is fine. I'm running and I'm crying.
Wake up, grab a brush and put a little makeup. This starts to fade away, the shake up. Why'd you leave your keys up on the table? Here you go, create another fable. Grab a brush and put a little makeup. Hide the scars to fade away, the shake up. Why'd you leave your keys up on the table?
I don't think you trusted my self-righteous suicide. I cry when angels deserve to die, 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 die.
Hey!
I'm gonna get free. I'm gonna get free. I'm gonna get free.
Right into the sun.
But it bears repeating now.
But you are
last night. She said,
"Oh,
baby, don't you feel so down?
Feel so down
when you turn me on?
You turn me on
when I feel left out." So I,
what'd you do?
Well, I turned around.
Right around.
Oh, baby, gonna be all right. It was a great big lie.
Big ol' lie.
Cause I left that night.
Shady, please.
cats and a year's supply of Clone Wars, the San Francisco treat. But that's not all. You also made yourself look like a complete jerk in front of millions of people. You brought shame and disgrace to your family name for generations to come. You don't get to come back tomorrow. You don't even get a lousy copy of our home game. You're a complete loser.
Don't know what I was thinking of. I guess I just wasn't too bright. Well, I sure hope I do better next weekend on The Price is Right. I lost on Jeopardy, baby.
Can't watch this. Can't watch this. Can't watch this. I can't watch this. My TV makes me so bored. Makes me say, oh my lord, what is this garbage? She wanna cover my eyes and plug my ears. It sucks. And that's no lie. It's about as much fun as watching paint dry. Lowers my IQ one notch. And that's the reason why I can't watch. I told you, homeboy, I can't watch this. Yeah, nothing but trash. And you know, I can't watch this. Poke out my eyes, man. I can't watch this. Yo, give me that remote control. I can't watch this talking about six shows as America's funniest home videos. I can't believe my eyes when I see the kind of stuff that wins first prize. Some buddies. Poor old mom falls down off the roof, lands right on the lawn, face first. On a rake, I hear they've got it on the 17 tape. That's funny. As a kid in the garage, and that kind of show, I can't watch. Yo, I told you. I can't watch this. Change the channel now, man. I can't watch this. Yo, pass the TV guide here, so I can't watch this. I'm for real, listen. Can't watch this Cosby Show. Roseanne, think I've taken about as much as I can. Judge Wapner. Oh my, you gotta be Raymond to like this guy, 30-something. It's alright if you like hearing yuppies wanting all night. Can't stand Twin Peaks, wish they'd lynch those bleeding freaks. Those Siskel and Ebert bums oughta go home and just sit on their thumbs. That's work because you know, can't watch this. Can't watch this. Look, break it down. Stop. Prime time, I'm pretty sure I'll be sick if I have to watch another Super Pet Trick or that guy with the real flat hair that goes wolf, wolf, wolf and ways his fist in the air. Are those weird? Talk shows about transsexual Nazi Eskimos. They're rude, cruel, and vile. Just for a minute, let's flip down the dial. Flip, flip, flip. Ugh. I can't watch this. Look, man, look. I can't watch this. I can't take this torture anymore. I can't watch this. Pay the bills, station break. Break it down. Cable time, HBO and Playboy, Showtime and MTV. I might like them more after my lobotomy. Now why did I ever pay for this junk? I hooked up 80 channels and each one stunk. Just brainless blood and guts and mindless TNA. It's awful, it's putrid, it's crummy, it's stupid. Gonna throw my set away. Can't watch this. Can't watch this. Watch this. Yeah. Can't watch this. I told you. Dude, can't watch this. Yo. Get me out of here. Turn off your television. Go outside. Ride a bicycle.
One, two, three, four, one, two. I was driving on the freeway in the fast lane with the rabid Wolverine in my underwear when suddenly a guy behind me in the backseat popped right up and cupped his hands across my eyes. I guessed, is it Uncle Frank or Cousin Louie? Is it Bob or Joe or Walter? Could it be Bill or Jim or Ed or Bernie or Al? I probably would have kept on guessing, but about that time we crashed into the truck. And as I'm laying bleeding there on the asphalt, finally I recognize the face of my hibachi dealer, who takes off his prosthetic lips and tells me, everything you know is wrong. Black is white, up is down, and short is long. And everything you thought was just so important doesn't matter. Everything you know is wrong. Just forget the words and sing along. All you need to understand is that everything you know is wrong. I was walking to the kitchen for some golden grams when I accidentally stepped into an alternate dimension, and soon I was abducted by some aliens from space who kind of looked like Jamie Farr. They sucked out my internal organs and they took some Polaroids and said I was a darn good sport. And as a way of saying thank you, they offered to transport me back to any point in history that I would care to go. And so I had them send me back to last Thursday night so I could pay my phone bill on time. Just then the floating disembodied head of Colonel Sanders started yelling, everything you know is wrong. Black is white, up is down, and short is long. And everything you thought was just so important doesn't matter. Everything you know is wrong. Just forget the words and sing along. All you need to understand is everything you know is wrong. When I got a nasty paper cut, and well, to make a long story short, it got infected and I died. So now I'm up in heaven with St. Peter by the pearly gates, and it's obvious he doesn't like the narrow jacket that I'm wearing. He tells me that they've got a dress code. Well, he lets me into heaven anyway, but I get the room next to the noisy ice machine for all eternity. And every day he runs by screaming, hey, is wrong. Black is white, up is down, and short is long. And everything you used to think was so important doesn't really matter anymore, because the simple fact remains that everything you know is wrong. Just forget the words and sing along. All you need to understand is everything you know is, everything you know is, everything you know is wrong.
I've got all the porn I can get, so now I'm searching around the net for some Metallica albums I haven't downloaded yet. They've had more misses than hits lately and greatly gone soft, but I do it just because I know it pisses them off. I go on another hunt and check another locale for stuff I want and find a folder titled Older Weird Al. It's news to me, but here's an early Billy Joel parody by Buggery called It's Still Just a Hole to Me. Believe me when I tell you the shock value astounds. It's a catchy little ditty using crappy MIDI sounds, recorded by a team working in a machine shop, and the singer sounds like William Hung gargling a mop. How could anyone think Al had this done? Oh right, the average IQ online is 81, so I give up. I don't even try to understand why these songs are written by this wired all Yankovic guy.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
Nuh-uh.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
No way.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
He'd never sing about how to use a fish as a pawn. Come on.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
Nuh-uh.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
No way. But he did do a movie with Long Duck Dong.
What's happening, pop star?
Stupid! You're so stupid!
First of all, let's talk about the spelling of weird. It's W-E-I-R-D. See, just to be clear, the I before E thing doesn't apply, because weird is just a weird word. That's that's why. His full name is Alfred, not Alan or Alex. But it's not a secret like that guy who's fighting the Daleks. If you have trouble recollecting his name, there's a game. Imagine him preparing dinner for a young Bruce Wayne. But really, you don't even need to know that bit. His name is Al, call him Al, A-L, and that's it. His name is two letters long, but I included in this song because a disturbingly large number of people get it wrong. Finally, let's talk about his last name. It drives me insane. Singing Yankovic should be profane. If you can't spell his name, I'ma show you how. Now it's Yankovic with a C. There's no H. Say it with me now. There is no H in Yankovic. Say it. There is no H in Yankovic. Again. There is no H in Yankovic. Louder.
There is no H in Yankovic. Weird Al didn't write this song. Weird Al didn't write this song.
No way.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
And he's never been on stage in high heels and a thong.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
Wrote the tribute to the size of my schlong.
Hey, yo, Devo Spice, I'ma let you finish, but Sea Monkey writes the best wiener parodies ever. I'm just saying.
Just because the song is funny doesn't mean it's done by Alan. Everyone I come upon threatens to give me a grimal. Does the same lack of knowledge make it back to other tracks? Just because the song sucks doesn't mean it's Nickelback. Yet every parody I see is credited wrong, as if he and only he can change the words to a song. The file sharing sites are uncaring how they store it. I'm still working on the song and I just found a torrent for it. Al works clean, so that should be your first clue that he didn't write the song about
an elephant. Is he?
And hello mada, hello fada, just in case there's any doubt. In fact, no, he didn't write it, he was four when it came out. Lots of other people write parodies too, and you can hear them on the funk every month when we do. Like Spaff and Robert Lund, Steve Goody, Luke Ski, Dynamite, Project Sisyphus, and oh yeah, me!
Weird Al didn't write this song.
Nuh-uh.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
No way.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
I don't care what the credits say, the credits are wrong.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
Nuh-uh.
Weird Al didn't write this song.
No way. That it was Al, but it was me all along.
Hey Devo, have you heard that track Inner Voice by Adam Sandler? It's hilarious.
Oh come on, are you kidding me? This is ridiculous. I wrote that song with Worm Quartet in 2005. Number one song on the Dr. Demento show. And I can't even get miscredited to Al. It has to go to Adam Sandler. Geez, what am I gonna do? How am I ever gonna get anywhere?
Oh, boy, that was fun. We started out there with Weird Al doing generic blues and angry white boy polka. And it's amazing what he does with the accordion. And his, I can't remember the exact lineage. I know he has an uncle. I'm not sure about his father. Anyway, they were famous polka accordionists. So he grew up with the accordion. Then it was Weird Al songs done by other folks. I lost on Jeopardy, MC Chris, and I Can't Watch This, MC Lars. And they both come out of when they're categorized nerdcore. And that's how I ended up here. I started to dove into some more recent nerdcore and then wanted to bring in some Al, and found a good dose of Al. So then we had Pac-Man done to the tune of Taxman by Nuclear Bubble Wrap, followed by Everything You Know Is Wrong, done by Steve Goody. And then we just heard Devo Spice doing Weird Al Didn't Write This Song. That's my first contact with Devo Spice. He's a lyricist out of New York, I think, somewhere in the U.S. I'm going to check him out a little more, plus I came across a couple other folks. I'm going to check out their stuff. We'll probably have some more humorous stuff coming up. So hope y'all enjoyed that. I feel better already. And we're going to take in some's a real special piece. It's called Al's Band by Al's Band. And his band's been together from, well, they tell the story of how they came together. But they've stayed together through the whole thing. And like I say, I saw them live and they're all really talented, really tight. I mean, the rehearsal time they put in had to have been just intense. I'm sure Al's a perfectionist. So taking us home here is Al's band doing Al's band. So I'll have a wonderful week. Take care.
Ever wonder what it's like in Al's band? Kind of complicated, but we'll tell you what we can. Lots of people ask us what goes on in Al's band. This is our song, and we'll start where we began. Back in the beginning, before we started, Al sent songs to Dr. Demento. Then met John, who played the drums, and then he said we should start a band. That was the moment the fun began. Steven, he became the bass man. He knew Jim, who played guitar, and then Al had his band. Early on, we did a show with Missy Persons, playing our best. We got booed by their fans. We put our first album in 3 days. After that, we knew what to do. We hit the road on tour, and then we were on our way. Happy to be playing our music for you. Started something, we got to make our second album. That's when Eat It was a hit and went gold, and it changed everything. We had a tour bus at our command. We knew to be stupid on plastic bovines with ice cream pressed against our foreheads. Johnny Carson asked if we would play polkas on his TV show. We got some help from the Tonight Show band. Polka party and went featuring Christmas at Ground Zero, and it didn't chart for too long, but it had some good songs. Joined a tour with the Monkees, going on the road with Mickey, Dave, and Pete was here. Even was the album where we did the fat song. Then to be in the video, which episodes we did the film score. After that, we found our keyboard man.
I am Ruben, how do you do?
We took him in and put him in a coma. Now he plays piano and he also plays accordion.
And jumped on top of the E-band and reached. Super big, just like the Chili Peppers do. Work it when we made that rock video.
Canada was next in line for Al's band. That was where we learned how to sing Saskatchewan.
We were getting popular outside our native land.
That opened the door to a world full of fans.
So we went to Ireland, to New Zealand.
Video. We were outstanding in our field.
Then we all went putting with the scissors. The saga began,
and it was more than all about
Candy Yums.
We were featured on The Simpsons as animated characters. An honor for all of us.
Never get tired of playing in Al's band. So much fun to play all the styles that we do.
How about a solo from the drummer of the band?
Take it now, Bermuda, don't make it too bland.
I'll add percussion to lend a hand.
See us play when you can.
Then you can see for yourself.